Girish has studied at Dundee. He did his MS from there. He is a graduate from Bombay University, and he worked with basically All Points Bulletin.
You still try to roll this out.
I don't know if you people know, but that was one of the first games to have, what we say, customized characterizations. So he'll tell you much more about what he's done. But from gaming to using gaming technologies for non-gaming application is Girish's biggest strength. And along with him, we have Dr. Praveen Yadav, an old associate actually, or rather I would say, I met him briefly in 98, and then I'm meeting him today. So that's how long basically we know each other. He's been in and around Pune. And he's, by doctor, he's a PhD. So you have to really take him seriously, because whatever he's done, he's worked with DreamWorks. So a lot of stuff he's done, and he'll tell you what he's doing now. And they're going to talk about Unity and immersive technologies, because if you notice, today's sessions were all high funda sessions, you know, and a lot of this stuff actually can be very heavy for students, but then they felt that, okay, boss, you can't protect people. If we have go to get talent, we have to basically tell them the real stuff, and then people will decide, okay, they want to do this stuff, or they are okay with doing their boring stuff. Okay, so these guys also want to show you some cutting edge stuff. There is augmented reality, virtual reality. They are working around the Oculus Rift and Google Glass, that kind of stuff. I thought they are going to show us Oculus Rift, but that's not going to happen. They have the Oculus Rift, but it's not for public demo at this point of time. But whatever they want to talk is important, because all of you are doing Unity, and some of you are interested in the Unity side of things and augmented reality, VR side of things. So they want to showcase whatever they have done, and that's quite a bit. And they're also working on stuff which is pretty futuristic, but I don't know how much they want to show about it. But let's hope that you get as much as possible. So to both of you.
And there's relevance for the next talk that we're doing. So basically our intention, so I, as Ali was saying, so I've worked, done my master's in computer games technology from Scotland. So it was at the University of Aberdeen, London. And there I was actually working with on the game called APB, which is a massively multiplayer online game. It was created by Dave Jones, the creator of Grand Theft Auto. So I was working with him, and the idea of APB was GTA marries World of Warcraft. So lots of people all around the world playing together in an open city environment. So getting this kind of a gameplay running in a massively multiplayer setup is extremely difficult, extremely challenging. So that was the game that we worked on in Scotland. This was in 2004. I came back in 2009 and I started Shunya. A company is called Shunya. And essentially the idea really was that we wanted to take games technology in a direction which people had never explored before. Working out how the technology and the applications can work out in domains apart from entertainment. Jitin just mentioned, no? Entertainment is the market that you're targeting. So what other markets could be targeted using the same technology? I mean, we've all grown up playing games. There's also this aspect of how you can leverage, so immersion, you know, everyone's talking about it. Games as a whole allow you to get immersed for like 5 hours, 6 hours. You don't realize the time. How you can actually take that whole aspect of immersion into different domains, into different industries, where maybe your work is more fun. You know, going to the office, why does it have to be boring? Can it be more exciting? So that's the angle that we try to focus on. And again, with reference to Jitin's talk, it was a new market altogether. So there's a lot of unexplored areas. There's no fixed elements that you end up following. Comparing different games that are already there, there's no reference. So there's a lot of creating from scratch that happens. So there's a lot of experimentation. And essentially, how do you approach this market? It's from scratch, right? You don't know what team setups are there. You don't know who's going to buy, how much people are going to pay. All these factors actually come in. So what we did over time was, our focus was on using 3D, because that 3D is where the immersion actually comes in, right? So 2D is there, 3D takes it to the next level. What all applications can one create using 3D technology? That's when we actually started the exploration. And so Praveen will actually take it forward, but essentially the reason why I'm just kind of jutting in right now is just whatever stuff that we talked about in the morning, just keep that aside and look at this as the other side of games technology, where you can actually potentially see where all technology, games technology could be used and how it can actually benefit a whole lot of different domains apart from just entertainment. So I'll just hand it over to Praveen.
Thanks, Girish. So let me, it was a good that we had a kind of like break. It was, I will say that it was a, let's have a, consider that one as an good break for our next leap. So while starting, let me talk about, make a bold statement that we are among the last few generations who will be actually depending on the direct interaction with the physical world to take any kind of like decision. So it might be some kind of like intimidating phrase for you, but let me repeat it once again so that I will make it somewhat clear, and I'll try to make it in explain it in simple words, that we are among the last few generations who will be interacting with the actual physical world to take any kind of like decision. So why it is happening something like that? Because now what happens is that there is a phenomenal amount of change, and we are anticipating that kind of change. Now, soon after, we will be shifting all our kind of like behavioral and interaction and all our total mental like understanding this this world, physical world, and it's our concepts, and everything is going to get a complete paradigm shift.